Hello everyone, this is Haisam Javed and in this video we are going to learn about the East India Company and its involvement in India. So, what was the East India Company? In 1583, Queen Elizabeth I dispatched a ship to the subcontinent to exploit opportunities for trade. 16 years after it sailed to India, Queen Elizabeth granted trading rights to a group of merchants from London. The company was granted the Royal Charter by Elizabeth in 1600. The EIC later went on to establish the British rule in India. But why did the EIC become involved in India? The Dutch had long been sea traders and were the greatest map makers in Europe. The Dutch continued to improve their ships, business techniques, and began establishing trade connections with Indonesia. Seeing the profits which the Dutch were making, Queen Elizabeth I joined the competition by permitting the English East India Company to set up and trade in India. The Dutch had progressed because of the spice trade. Europe did not grow its own spices and its people were sick and tired of eating the tasteless food which only had salt in it. So, the explorers from Europe would set out in search of spices, and India was rich in those. The British not only wanted to buy black pepper, they also wanted to buy other spices, various types of cotton, silk, jute, opium, sugar, saltpeter, and indigo. Because of the climatic conditions, cotton could not be grown in Britain. And since the 17th century, Britain had to import cotton from North America and India. Cotton yarn and cotton cloth were high in demand because cotton clothing was more comfortable than the woolen clothing that the British usually wore. Saltpeter was used to make gunpowder, and indigo was used to make dyes. This dye was in demand for coloring the Royal Navy's uniforms. The EIC encouraged the growth of opium in India to sell it to the Chinese and buy tea from China in return. Furthermore, India had a strategic position on the globe. It would give regional supremacy to the British Royal Navy. They would also be able to control the sea routes and hence trade with the East. Initially, the EIC was only interested in trade and not in any kind of politics. But the decline of the Mughal Empire, disunity among the Indians, and the lack of central government led to the British take interest in the local politics. Moreover, they saw an opportunity to promote Christianity and their Western culture as well. Next up would be the British expansion in India. Stay tuned.